Hello friends, welcome to our channel Stocks Factor. Hope you are doing well. Friends, we come up with yet another very important video in which we'll understand that currently who is the biggest and the smartest player in the market. Friends, this is the topic and I highly recommend you to watch this video till the end. So in the race of FII versus retail, who is the king? So friends, let's get started. So friends, we'll start with the retail participation and we'll quickly see the data points in which we'll see that how the retail customer accounts has grown over a period of time. So as you can see here, number of investor accounts. So this is the NSDL and the CDSL data, and you can see the number of accounts opening for both of them starting from December 2009 till March 21. So as you can see, this represents the total number of retail accounts which has grown over a period of time. And this graph tells you the new addition every year. So basically here we are taking that cumulative sum and here we are just taking the new accounts which has opened. So as you can see, in the FY21 a lot many accounts have been opened, and in the FY20, so both these year combined they contribute to huge account openings. So in the past 2 years, huge number of accounts have been opened by retail investors and a new retail investor has come to the market. So this gives us the data point of the retail participation which has increased in the overall market. Now friends, let's see whatever accounts have been opened, let's see whether retail customers are active or not in the market. So let's begin with the NSE cash market turnover, and here we are starting the data point from FY16 till FY21. So as you can see, FII's participation has reduced overall in the cash market turnover. By turnover I mean the number of trades happening, the volume happening per day, right? So you can see FIIs are trading less, and see this number, the yellow one, you see it is increasing. Now the retail participant, it means the retail customer, is contributing 45% of the total cash turnover which is happening in the National Stock Exchange. So this is the National Stock Exchange data, and 25% are the pros. Now friends, let's come up with another data point that is very important in terms of trend in share of client participation in equity derivatives. That is, here we talked about cash market turnover or the volume, now we are talking about the client participation in the equity derivatives, that is the futures and options segment. And here also you can see, and retail participation in FY22 is 24.4%, and in FY21 it was almost 30%, and you can see the participation of FIIs, it is 20.9% and 19.3% in FY22, which is lesser than the client participation. So it means client is participating more in the volume generated for the equity derivatives as well, similar to the cash market. So in both segments, cash and F&O, retail participation has increased and it has surpassed FIIs. Now friends, the question arises that if the retail participation has increased over the years, is the retail the smartest investor in the market now, or is the retail investor holding the maximum number of stocks as compared to FIIs now? Let's figure that out and we'll answer that question in the next few slides. Who has the upper hand? So friends, let's look at the data points and let's see the retail participation now. So as you can see here, NSE listed universe trend. Now here we are talking about the holding of the market. So now as you can see, the question we are answering now, that in the complete NSE listed universe trend, retail holding is only 9%, and you can see FII's holding is 21.5%. Domestic mutual funds hold 7.2%, and you can see banks, other insurance companies, and the banks, they are holding 5.1%, and obviously the promoters, they hold the maximum number of shareholding in any company. But can you see this number, FIIs? So we can see 21.5% holding is for FIIs. So they still dominate the market as compared to domestic mutual funds and retail investors. Let me show you the other data point. FIIs ownership dipped marginally following a sharp jump in the previous quarter. So you can see here, FII share only fell by 14 basis points, 24 basis points and 27 basis points in Nifty 50, Nifty 500 and Nifty listed universe. So these are the shareholdings. So you can see Nifty 50 companies, they are approximately holding 27% of the total share which are tradable in the market. So you can see 27.4% they are holding, and you can see the retail investor is only holding 9% in the whole universe. We'll see other figures too. Direct retail share remains steady. Individual retail investors holding in NSE listed companies and Nifty 500 companies remained broadly steady at 9% only and 8.6% respectively. So you can see in the Nifty 50 index, they are holding approximately 8.1%, and in the total NSE listed universe, we saw that it is 9%. So friends, now you can figure out who is the biggest and the smartest investor yet, who is holding the major stocks in Nifty 50 companies and the Nifty listed universe. It is the FIIs. And now let us share few more data points with you. So you can see here NSE 50 owner partnership patterns. Again, we are seeing the same figures. FIIs 27.4% and retail 8.1%. And in the Nifty 500, top 500 companies, retail only 8.6% and FII 22.2%. So friends, clearly we can see that though retail participation in the total volume and the turnover has increased, but the actual shareholding of the retail investor has decreased. So retail is not holding the stock. FIIs are holding the majority of the portion as compared to the retail investors. Now let's share the overall trends. So what we saw in the pie charts was the current snapshot. Now we'll see the historical trend, how the FIIs and retail participation or the shareholding has increased or decreased. So let's first see the retail. As you can see, since March 2001 till March 21, you can continuously see that the retail participation has decreased and now it has become stagnant. So retail, though, is trading a lot in the market, but is not actually holding the stock for a longer period of time. As contrast to this, you can see the FIIs holding this dotted green line. It has continuously increased over the span of 20 years and now they are holding, you can see, around 22% of the total shareholders by total market cap. So this is the market cap they are holding. So what the market cap is, number of outstanding shares, the market capitalization of the company. So they are holding around 22.7%, and obviously promoters will be holding more because promoters, they hold the majority of the shares. Now friends, let's see in this universe, if we exclude the promoters, what is the contribution of FIIs and retail. So in this graph we'll see, you can see that retail participation is again very less. It is less than 20% currently and it has continuously decreased over the years. And now you see the FII participation. So you can see it has continuously increased and it is currently between 40 to 45%, around 43%. So as compared to retail, the FIIs are holding the double the quantity as compared to the retail. So still the FIIs are the biggest and the smartest players in the market. So friends, you need to take this into account and you have to bust your myth that retail is the smartest player. Still, FIIs are the smartest player. Retail has only increased the number of trades or the volume in the market. They are not holding the stocks. So friends, that brings me to the very important question, where are the big players investing? That is the FIIs, where are they actually investing? So you can see institutional money has remained concentrated to larger companies, with FIIs and domestic mutual funds having 93% and 85% of their investments towards only top 10% companies. If there are total, suppose 2000 companies, so only in the 200 companies, FIIs have mostly invested, and also the domestic mutual funds. You can see 93% of the FIIs holding is in the top 200 companies, and that includes the Nifty 50 companies and the quality mid-cap stocks. FIIs contribution in those stocks is the largest. So that is the point to be noted. And again, let us bring some other stats. Share of investments toward top 10% companies by market caps. So still you can see FIIs and domestic mutual funds, they almost, whatever we saw here, so 93% actually FIIs are holding, and you can see domestic mutual funds are way behind them. FIIs are actually holding the majority of the shares in top 10% companies, so their contribution is more after the promoters, right? Now again, coming to another data point, as you can see here, seeing the distribution of the FIIs holding in Nifty 50, top 10%, Nifty 500, all listed. So we can see in the Nifty 50 companies, we already saw that they hold 27.4%. In top 10%, that is 200 companies, around 23.6%. Nifty 500, that is the first 500 companies, 22.2%, and all NSE listed companies, we already saw that in the earlier slide, that is 21.5%. And look at the domestic mutual funds and other companies. So FIIs are clearly the biggest player in the market. They are the smartest player. They hold the stock for a longer period of time. What retail investor is doing, it is not holding the stock. They just keep selling the stock over a period of time. Only 1% of the retail investors, that is the biggest players like pros in the market, they are holding the stock. So friends, that brings us to the point that what conclusion we can draw from this analysis. So the first is retail participation has increased. That is the direct investment in the number of shares, because we already saw that Demat accounts have increased, and they are also investing in the market through mutual funds. Second point, direct retail participation merely impacting volume. So clearly from this analysis, we have come to the conclusion that retail participation has only impacted the volumes. But in terms of holding, FIIs are the biggest player. FIIs still hold the upper hand and they are clearly the market players and they are the biggest and the smartest investors. As you already saw that recently Nifty corrected and we already saw that almost 800 points correction happened from 18,600 and it was very well correlated with the FII selling. So friends, if we look at the FII DII page and if we see the pattern, as I was mentioning that majority of the selling, as you can see in the previous few days, FIIs were selling continuously and this led to the fall in the Nifty. So as you can see, Nifty was falling continuously from the past few days and this can be correlated with the FII selling. But this doesn't mean that there would be a major correction happening. So as you can see, if we go down, if we look at the month by month data, so in October month, they actually sold around 25,000 crores and in the current month, they have already sold for 4,000 crores. In contrast to that, DIIs only bought less than 5,000 crores and in the current month, they have actually bought more than what FIIs have sold. So that's why we saw the correction in October from 18,600 to 17,700. So this was the reason of the fall of almost 1,000 points. So in the bull market, we will see the corrections like this, 7 to 8% corrections happening in the market. But for a long-term investor, you need to take into account that these corrections are good for you to make a fresh entry for a long-term perspective. So if you are a long-term investor and you want to hold the stock for 5 years at least, so these corrections will help you to accumulate good quality stocks, especially Nifty 50 stocks and the FNO stocks in the good sectors. You can pick up your stocks for the long-term holding. You can do your small buyings in such corrections. So friends, with this note, we want to highlight one very important point that please, if you are a long-term investor, hold the stock for a period of time. Don't sell the stock for a small profit. So you need to buy in the small dips in a bull market, but you have to wait and hold that stock because the bull market is going to continue with such corrections. So friends, hope you like this video. If you have any questions regarding this video, please post your questions on the comment section and we will definitely answer your questions. If you have not subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel to get the notifications of such videos so that you can understand how to do the holistic analysis and how to identify high probability trades. And friends, if you want to get the access of our dashboard, please visit our website www.stocksfactor.com. See you in another video. Take care and goodbye.